partner at Zinnov joins in now. Siddharth, many thanks for joining in on this show. My first question to you, how does this change the dynamic? In 2 years from now, do you expect there to be only a Flipkart and Amazon left, or would this be perhaps a game of about 3 to 4 players?
Yes, that's a good point. And what I would like to say is, one of the things that we must be cognizant of is that this is a down round. Flipkart's valuation is nowhere close to the $15.2 billion that it was valued in 2015. And as you said, $2.5 billion invested by SoftBank gives them about 20% stake. So we can all see that that's a huge downside, so $10 billion versus a $15 billion valuation. And the reason for that, I think, is obvious. We have seen burgeoning of multiple players, and SoftBank has been trying really hard to consolidate this space. The snap deal thing went through. They already have a stake in Paytm. So I think for a sustainable market, I think we will definitely see only two large players emerging: Amazon, which is really, really big, investing $5 billion plus. And then there would be Flipkart, at least in the full services retail segment, that is what they would see.
And do you see a case for valuation expansion for Flipkart? If yes, by how much? Given the fact that there have been large investors, including eBay, Microsoft, Tencent, that have very recently invested, do you see a case for valuation expansion? If yes, by how much?
Yes, I think you will see valuation expansion primarily because of the impending consolidation. And as we've already seen Flipkart gobble up Myntra, it's gobbled up eBay, all of these smaller players have consolidated into it. So as this continues to happen, we will definitely see valuation expansion.
Siddharth, you spoke about Amazon and Flipkart being neck to neck. Does Flipkart have the muscle to be able to? Because the fact is, Amazon is back with a $5 billion war chest. They are expected to put in more into the Indian operation. Is there a case for Flipkart to be able to beat Amazon in terms of market share in near term?
So if you look at the technology space and what differentiates Amazon from some of the others, globally, Amazon has great scale. Amazon has the best of the processes, etc. But if you look at the India infrastructure, the India processes, I think Amazon is still to get there. And both the companies are almost neck to neck in terms of their technology, in terms of their back-end infrastructure, in terms of the way they're deploying technology. I would, and if you see the kind of investment, I think right now Flipkart does have enough muscle. You yourself mentioned that it has about a $4 billion cash. So it does have the muscle to fight through this. And one of the interesting things is, you know, Amazon itself is leveraging India a lot in its technology fight. So, yeah, I think it is a level.
So, you know, Siddharth, where would the investment need to go in for Flipkart to be able to scale up significantly, beat an Amazon? What are the areas, be it technological upgradation, going aggressive on acquisition as it has been in the past?
So in my mind, the main areas of investment would be technology, technology in terms of delivery, technology in terms of the customer experience. I mean, both these things are extremely important. And this is where, if you see globally, Amazon has a lead. Flipkart is getting there. And technology is new. I think both the players can reach there.
Okay, last question, Siddharth. Do you expect Snapdeal to worry and perhaps relook at a possible merger with Flipkart? The fact is, they are backed with Microsoft, Tencent, SoftBank. Would Snapdeal now perhaps relook at the deal?
I don't think they would relook. I think they've had enough time to deliberate over this. I think what they will try and do is find a space in what I call a tier two retail player. And that is exactly what we would see. And the bigger play will be left to the big boys of Amazon and Flipkart.
So you'd say tier one would be Flipkart, Amazon, and the tier two would be at least 4 to 5 players?
Yes. I think it will be lesser than 4 to 5 in the near term. But yes, Snapdeal will stay there for a while.
Okay, fair enough, Siddharth. Many thanks for joining in on the show. Ron, it's been 6 months of negotiations. SoftBank gone ahead and finally made that investment. Let's see if Snapdeal is worried.